night before, I spent 2 hours making making notes on what I wanted to cover in the visit. Put my notes in a safe place by my purse so that I could remember to take them. But what happened is that I totally forgot to take them with me, which I kind of do a lot now at Parkinson's.
My neurologist has a nurse practitioner, so it's really right now the nurse practitioner that I see or spend the most time with.
So some of the things I noticed had changed from my last visit. I have dystonia in my, well, it's in both feet, but it's kind of got worse in my left foot. The only thing about when you go into the doctor and you tell them all your symptoms, they tend to treat you with more medication, so you have to keep that in mind. Although you want to make sure that you do discuss every symptom with them to make sure it's related to the Parkinson's, and also to make sure that it's documented in your medical
file.
My hair falling out, and this kind of has been an ongoing problem. And usually what I do is take a multivitamin. Well, actually I've been taking a prenatal, because that's what my original naturopath gave me when that happened. And I usually take it for a couple of weeks, and then I usually have that problem go away. But it's kind of reoccurring, and recently it's been pretty bad. So, you know, I asked if it was okay to continue with the multivitamin, and she said, yes, that's fine. So I discussed my medication. I'm on Sinemet. I can't talk today. And I take 9 pills a day, and so it's kind of spread out every 3 hours, and I'm unmedicated at night. And what I told her is that my medication just isn't working at all. It doesn't feel, like usually you can feel an on period and an off period, but I don't feel like any of that on off anymore. Which is kind of normal. That's kind of what happens with the Sinemet. It gets to be less effective, or what they say is that your Parkinson's gets worse. And so they do have to watch that, and that's the, like, the movements that kind of look like you have Parkinson's.
Well,
that's what people assume you have.
A tremor.
It's not really a tremor. It's from the medication. And it's not always, like, I do move like this sometimes. If I take too much medication or if I'm under medicated, it's just a temporary phase. Like, it's just purely to do with your medication, so it's not permanent.
Yeah,
so I have, like, repetitive movements, and you can tell, like, my eyes flicker. Like, they change focus a lot, and it just looks like maybe I'm shy or something, but really it's... I don't notice I'm doing it, but it has to do with the
dyskinesia. Other thing I do
is kind of, I have like a couple of tics right now. So one tic is that, like, I'm always cold, which I am always cold, but I'll always like rub my hands more in my lap though. That sounds kind of strange. And then another tic I have is that I can look like I'm kind of restless, but I'm not. I always have her, like, you know, when they want to increase my medication, I always like try and do without that increase for another 6 months. Sometimes they spread out my Sinemet, like they'll keep the same 9 and like reallocate it, and that kind of extends my time, because I don't want to take too much medication. And I don't want to get to the point where my dyskinesia is a problem.
So last time,
she had given me a couple of medications that she felt would be useful. So I've been researching those medications. So before I went in,
I knew what approach I wanted to take. And I've been wanting to take
amandidine.
I've been kind of curious about the flu. That I have noticed that when I take flu medicine that my Parkinson's gets a little bit better and my pain gets a lot better. Like, it's the only time that I don't have
pain. And the other choice was a new medication that just came on the market, and
I don't remember the name of it, but it's a new drug that's sort of like Sinemet, but supposed to be like
she
more
did
effective.
That
test, you know, when they do things like this. And I guess every visit they track you. They track if your symptoms are getting worse or temporarily better, and they have some kind of scale. Discuss the side effects of the amandidine. Now, it does have side effects, but like I said, I'm considering it, and I'm no expert. A little bit less taxing on the body than some of the other Parkinson meds, so that's why I don't mind trying it. It's an antiviral medication for the flu that they found out works in Parkinson's. I was looking at the side effects before I went in there, so I knew what the side effects were to discuss with her. So she brought up some of the stuff that was on there. I've also seen things about purple skin, that it turns the skin purple. So I brought that up. And she said she'd never really seen that, but that is a side effect. And then I was sort of thinking in my head, that really doesn't sound too bad. And I thought, like, well, how bad does it have to get where you think purple skin is okay?
And then the other
kind of big effect is that you could get swelling in your ankles or your lower leg for some reason. I don't know why. Again, that's pretty serious side effects. But again, when you compare that to the Sinemet side effects, and I still have to take Sinemet or some of the other like Parkinson's drugs, they really don't seem too bad.